carburetor. Never heard of her.
There's actually a hidden physics principle in the working of a carburetor. Let's talk about it.
First, let's understand the relation between velocity and cross-sectional area. On the left, the cross-sectional area is larger than the right, and the rate of fluid flow entering and exiting the tube has to be the same. So the particles must increase their velocity as they move through the tube to match the rate of fluid flow. This is explained by A1V1 equals A2V2. Now, let's look at the relationship between velocity and pressure. We know air particles must accelerate as they travel to the smaller area as the velocity increases. Using Newton's second law of force equals mass times acceleration, and because the mass is constant and the acceleration is positive, there must exist a force, specifically a rightward net force exerted onto the particle. Pressure is defined as force over area, and because F1 is greater than F2, the pressure in region 1 is greater than region 2. This is represented through Bernoulli's equation. In this case, height, density, and force of gravity are all constant, thus proving Bernoulli's principle that as the velocity of a fluid increases, its pressure decreases. What's this got to do with carburetors? A carburetor follows the Bernoulli principle. The carb has standing air and fuel particles inside, and when you push the throttle valve opens while fast air flows in, creating a low pressure zone with less particles. The air in the jet and fuel will flow up together to achieve equilibrium. The fuel comes out the jet and mixes with the air, which gets pushed into the engine where combustion will make the vehicle move.